Hello student, welcome to our next video of class 7 geography, chapter 7, human environment, settlement, transport and communication. Students, in the previous video, we have discussed about settlement and its types. And today, we will discuss about the introduction of transport, major means of transport and communication. Well, let's start. Students, first of all, we will try to understand about the transport. Students, transport is the means by which people and goods move. In the early days, it took a great deal of time to travel long distances. People had to walk and used animals to carry their goods. Invention of the wheel made transport easier. With the passage of time, different means of transport developed, but even today, people use animals for transport. The early traders from other countries used to take several months to reach India. They took either the sea route or the land route. Aeroplanes have made travel faster. Now it takes only 6 to 8 hours to travel from India to Europe. Modern means of transport thus saves time and energy. Students, the four major means of transport are roadways, railways, waterways and airways. Now we will discuss about the roadways. The most commonly used means of transport, especially for short distances, are roads. They can be metalled or unmetalled. Students, several types of materials like charcoal, rubber, cement or mixture of these used for construction of metal roads. Students, there are several national and state highways in India. The latest development in India is the construction of expressways. For example, you can take the example of Yamuna Expressway. The Golden Quadrilateral connects Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai and Kolkata. Students, with the ever-growing population, subways and flyovers have made to manage the traffic scenario. Subway is an underground passage which allows people and traffic to move. Flyovers are bridges that carry a road over another road. Now, railways. Railways carry passengers and goods over long distances quickly and cheaply. The railway network is well developed over the plain areas. Now, railway lines are also laid in difficult mountain terrain. Indian Railways has the largest network of railways in Asia. Railway engines that drive a chain of rail coaches are called locomotives. There are at present three types of locomotives: electric, diesel electric and diesel. Steam locomotives are no longer used. In the case of electric locomotives, power is supplied by overhead cables. Diesel and electric engines have largely replaced the steam engines. In places, super fast trains have been introduced to make the journey faster. Some of the latest development in railways are the Vande Bharat Express, metro trains, etc. The Indian Railways is also working for the construction of bullet trains as well. Students, do you know? The Trans-Siberian Railway is the longest railway system which connecting St. Petersburg in western Russia to Vladivostok on the Pacific coast. Here in the given map, you can see the Trans-Siberian Railroad. Now, waterways. Waterways have been in use since times immemorial. It is the cheapest means of transportation for carrying heavy and bulky goods over long distances. There are mainly of two types of waterways: inland waterways and sea route. Navigable rivers and lakes are used as inland waterways. Some of the important inland waterways are the Ganga Brahmaputra river system, the Great Lakes in North America and River Nile in Africa. Sea routes and oceanic routes are mostly used for transporting merchandise and goods from one country to another. These routes are connected with the ports. Students, in this map you can see the major seaports of the world. Now, airways. This is the fastest way of transport developed in the early 20th century. It is also the most expensive due to the high cost of fuels. Air traffic is adversely affected by bad weather like fog and storm. It is the only mode of transport to reach the most remote and distant areas, especially where there are no roads and railways. Helicopters are extremely useful in most inaccessible areas and in time of calamities for rescuing people and distributing food, water, clothes and medicines. In this map, you can see the major airports of the world. Now come to the next topic, communication. So first of all, we will discuss what is communication. Students, communication is the process of conveying messages to others. बच्चों, communication का मतलब यह होता है कि किसी भी संदेश को एक आदमी से दूसरे आदमी तक या दूसरे लोगों के समूह तक पहुंचाना. With the development of technology, humans have devised new and fast modes of communication. The increase in modern technologies have resulted in the formation of various modes of communication. This advancement has almost brought about an information revolution in the world. Communication today is described as a way of life, emphasizing the society's increasing reliance on this media. Students, through newspaper, radio and television, we can communicate with a large number of people. They are therefore called mass media. The satellites have made communication even faster. Now we can send electronic mails or emails through internet. Wireless telephonic communication through cellular phones have become very popular today. Internet not only provides us with worldwide information and interaction, but has also made our lives more comfortable. Now, we can reserve tickets for railways, airways and even cinemas and hotels sitting at home. With this kind of interconnectivity of people, services and institutions across the world, we are a large global society. Now, let's rewind what we have learned. Transport is the means by which people and goods move. The four major means of transport are roadways, railways, waterways and airways. Communication is the process of conveying messages to others. Now, I will ask some questions to you based on today's topic. Your first question is, which mode of transport is most suitable to reach an island? And your options are A. Ship, B. Train, C. Bus, D. None of these. And your right answer is option A, ship. Your second question is, which is not a means of communication? And your options are A, telephone, B, book, C, table, D, television. And your right option is option C, table. Your third question is, which type of road is constructed under the ground? And your options are A, flyover, B, expressways, C, subways, D, district road. And your right answer is option C, subways. Your fourth question is, which vehicle does not pollute the environment? And your options are A, cycle, B, bus, C, car, D, aeroplane. And your right answer is option A, cycle. Now it's time for practice. Students, these are the some of the questions for your homework. Students, we will present soon with the next video. Thank you.